But fate was about to smile upon him. The same wind that had long ago freed him from the priesthood would soon set him free from his dead-end assignment. The great white spot, just across the puddle from Cancun, hovering off the coast of New Orleans, would be his salvation. Within months of its appearance, Special Agent J.J. Speed was reassigned to the Big Easy. The situation in New Orleans had not, after all, gone unnoticed. Every week, against the advice of proper authorities, untold thousands were traveling to within spitting distance of the Great White Spot and returning home to talk in spry tones about something no authority could possibly comprehend. People were returning home, if they returned home at all, and doing whatever they wanted to do. Quitting their jobs, changing their lives, walking away. The Great White Spot, it appeared, quite apart from decimating their economic structures, was exerting a tangible influence on their culture. A culture those in power labored so mightily to direct. Naturally, they could not abide by this circumstance. It was not that civilization was in immediate danger of being abandoned, but still, any such impulse has to be crushed if order is to be sustained. The concept that you actually don't have to do any particular thing has always had a way of spinning out of history's control. At least until they could discover how to dissipate the Great White Spot, this emerging emancipation had to be contained. Consequently, a network of agents was ordered to New Orleans. Under a broad directive, they were to observe and report on what was happening. Ethnographic espionage, they called it, civil surveillance, staying deep undercover, revealing themselves not even to each other, penetrating whatever underground was spawning this newfound anarchy. Special Agent J.J. Speed grinned broadly when he received the assignment. The CIA isn't legally permitted to engage in domestic espionage, but every spy worth his decoder ring knows that disinformation and disruption are the only things holding the social system together.